Oh, hey everybody. So today, you know, if you don't know, I bake sourdough bread. And this is my whole container of the sourdough starter. And I can tell you this is the one that I actually started by myself. And I need to, basically I want to transfer this into a new container, like a glass one, which I think, you know, this one is fine as long as there is no like mold and everything like that, like, you know, but this one I haven't refreshed it. I haven't feed this for like, you know, a few days, and basically it needs to be fed. And like right now, like, you know, you cannot really see it, but on top of this it has that vinegar sort of layer, so which is not kind of okay if you don't plan on, you know, I don't plan on using it, so you know it's good to have that. But I was thinking of maybe baking like, you know, more sourdough bread again, so I want to refresh this. So here, let me show you what it looks like right now. So, you know, it's a little like, you know, has a water. Let me go there.
Okay. Ooh, I don't know whether you can see it, but
as you can see that it has that liquidy, like, you know, layer on top, which is okay. It's actually vinegar. And if I just, you know, don't do anything with this, it should be okay. As you can see that, you know, this one has like that layer on top. So basically I just want to refresh it with the, you know, with the bread flour or high gluten flour and some water, and that's it. So, you know, and one thing that you see is actually the scale. So when you actually make bread, I can tell you this, having the scale is probably the most important thing to use when baking. Because, you know, yes, in the recipe, they always tell you to use, you know, 5 cups of flour or like 3 cups of flour and those kind of things. But one thing you have to keep in mind is this. Every season is different in terms of moisture in the air. Basically, your flour will be different in terms of weight. So you basically, you know, if it's winter, it may actually be a little drier, so the flour will be lighter because there's no moisture in the air. When it's, you know, rainy monsoon season, for example, you know, then you have like flour that a little heavier. So the consistency of the flour is, you know, the consistency of the flour is changed according to the temperature and the climate that you're living in. So having the scale is actually going to make everything consistent. Yes, it is a little, like, you know, hassle to actually have to weigh everything, but in the long run, you actually have more consistent results. You know, so basically, when I teach, like, you know, I teach my friends how to bake bread, one thing that I tell them is they need a scale, because I'm not going to, you know, I rather weigh the ingredients than, you know, putting the 5 cups of flour or 3 cups of flour, because it is going to change. And especially, you know, professional bakers, they all use scales because that's how they can get consistency out of it. You know, so if you want to have good results every time, get the scale. It's actually really cheap and it's really easy to use. Like, you know, it's, you know, out of the questions, you need the scale. So basically, what I need to refresh this, so, you know, if you wanted to start a starter for your sourdough, basically what you need is only flour and water. And basically you put the flour in here, you know, because this one is kind of funky. I mean, I will use this a little bit to refresh it. But basically, if you need to start your own starter for the sourdough, basically you need flour and water, and that's it, you know, and you mixed it and you cover it up for, you know, maybe if you start off fresh, you know, without people who give you the starter like this, then basically you refresh it, like, you know, the first I'm gonna leave, like, for example, if it's, the temperature is warm, then, you know, I would leave the ingredients mixture for maybe a week, and then I refresh it again, you know, and then and you start to see, you know, you have to actually, like, observe what is going on in the mixture. Basically, there are a few things that you can see. So, you know, the glass or the clear container like this is good because you can see the bubbles. You can see the ingredients start to rise. And then another, you know, thing that I also tell people to actually observe is actually the smell. At the beginning of the mixture, the flour and the water, it just smell like flour, like wet flour. And you know what's like small wet flour, just like wet flour, it says nothing else. But then, you know, after a few days, after a week, for example, it starts to have a little sour, vinegary, like, smell. Like, if you don't smell that, that's fine, just throw out until you leave, like, a little bit. Like, you know, so for example, today I'm just gonna add the whole, like, you know, so when I refresh, you want to refresh every day, if you like baking. So, you know, I'm just gonna mix this. So, you know, not a lot, but that's more. So if you have friends who bake, you know, sourdough bread at home, you can definitely ask them for a little bit of their starter, because they have to throw out every time that they refresh it, which is basically, for example, if I bake every day, I have to refresh it every day, and basically I can throw them away. So, you know, this is not that much, but as you can see, it's not really a lot to start. You should have like about half of a centimeter here. And then, this is already weighted out, so I use the wet, so-called, like, you know, the wet starter, which is 1-to-1 ratio of water and flour. This is 100 grams of high gluten flour, or bread flour, and 100 grams of water, okay? And then, you know, if you want your starter to start it better, like, to start sooner, you can actually put this in a microwave just for 10 seconds, or the temperature is about, you know, 110, that's not that bad. And then your starter will actually start to get more active sooner. But, you know, so when you start like that, you have your friends giving you the starter, and put the, I already weighed this, so I'm just gonna put it there, so we don't miss, we don't make a mess. Okay. 100 grams of flour in, and 100 grams of water. Room temperature, regular water. Just gonna mix this. You know, just stir it in. You don't have to, like, rigorously stirring or anything, just make sure that everything is mixed. And, you know, clean out the sides. So, and, you know, any glass container is fine, any plastic container. Okay. Alright. So I get the mixture in. My hand is clean. So I can do this. Okay. I'm just gonna get everything that on the, my spatula here to get into the container. And then I just going to cover this up. And so basically, you are just trapping it in there, and, you know, like, don't, like, there you go, and that's it. And this is the sourdough starter, and then, you know, within probably tomorrow, like, so people usually do this, right? So if you want to see whether how active your starter is, like, if you start out fresh, you don't even want to try this, maybe, like, you know, week two or second week, you can start doing so. You have a rubber band and put it on the side of where you finish your mixture, And then, you know, you can see the rises in the starter. Maybe I'll make that video, I'll make the rising of the video the next one. So, you know, that's it. If you want to start your own starter for your sourdough, just flour and water, put it in a container, you know, 1-to-1 ratio, 100 grams of flour, 100 grams of water, and mix it in there. Wait for a week, refresh it with the same thing, 100 grams of flour and 100 grams of, you know, of the water. Usually you throw them out until you leave just a tiny bit of it, about, you know, a centimeter, like, you know, half an inch of the mixture in the at the bottom of it. You put the new flour in there, new water in there, and mix it together and cover it up. So basically that's what it is. So when it's actually really like going, I mean, basically, you know, every time you refresh, you will have a new starter every single day. So basically in the summertime, and sometimes I bake every day, because I was kind of like very, you know, feel bad to throw the mixture away. So I just, you know, bake every day instead. So if you don't want to bake every day, so there are ways to do that too. You know, you can put this mixture in the fridge. So instead of refreshing it every single day, you can refresh it once a week. That would actually kind of, you know, if you, based on your schedule of baking, right? So, you know, I'll talk about more about that in the next video, but today I'm just gonna show you how I refresh my starter. Okay, thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye.